Right, so let's go find Liara T'Soni. Dr. Liara T'Soni. Rocket Trooper. Jesus, that was quick. And I leveled up again. Nice! We're making good progress with these levels. A shock trooper. Oh, so it was a shock trooper, not a rocket trooper. And yes, the frame rate is terrible. I'm sorry. It's the game. I swear. Sniper. Lift. No, there's nothing in there. That it is. I'm pretty sure we're gonna have to, like, do something real quick. Yeah, we can't get in through there. So we need to go down, disable something, or find something. I can't actually holster my weapon. That is odd. Do-do-do-do-do. It is a long way down, Jesus. Bloody Nora. Bloody Nora. Nice drones. I'm taking damage, so shield booster. And then... Singularity. Just hold them in one spot. Yeah. It is just a giant tower. Do I need to go further down? Mother! Can we see the bottom? That's not good. Oh. Well, I'm assuming our elevator up is busted. Point of no return and all that.
Hello? Could somebody help me? Please?
Yep, I can't save. Shit.
Can you hear me out there? I'm trapped. I need help.
We hear you.
Are you okay? What happened to you?
Listen, this thing I'm in is a Prothean security device. I cannot move, so I need you to get me out of it, all right?
All righty, Benezia.
Your mother is working with Saren. Whose side are you on?
What? I am not on anybody's side. I may be Benezia's daughter, but I'm nothing like her. I have not spoken to her in years. Please, just get me out of here.
Trapped.
How'd you end up in there?
I was exploring the ruins when the Geth showed up, so I hid in here. Can you believe that? Geth, beyond the veil!
Yeah, I can.
I activated the tower's defenses. I knew the barrier curtains would keep them out. When I turned it on, I must have hit something I wasn't supposed to. I was trapped in here. You must get me out, please!
Stay calm, Liara. We'll get you out.
We'll find some way to help you.
There is a control in here that should deactivate this thing. You'll have to find some way past the barrier curtain. That's the tricky part. The defenses cannot be shut off from the outside. I don't know how you'll get in here. Be careful. There is a Krogan with the Geth. They have been trying different ways to get past the barrier.
Namely, probably blowing things up. Okay, make a quick little save. So the game doesn't deny me that again. More shock troopers. Well, there goes my barrier. I can... Yeah, I'll lift you and singularity the other guy. Well, I mean... If it looks stupid and it works, then it ain't stupid. Sniper again.
Perimeter secured.
Feels so nice to like get used to the weapon systems again. You know, once you got the powers down and like cycling between them. It's a bit of a breeze. It's quite nice, I must admit. Can I open you? There we go. Y, X, Y, X, Y, A, X. Thought we were done. Rex plus. Thank you. Y, B, B, Y, B, A, A. Thought that was going to be A, X or something like that. Ooh, got a rank 5 pistol. What do we got? What do we got? And it's just better all round. Fuck yes. Anything else? Nada. I'm actually gonna save because I don't want to go through all of that again and not get a pistol. The, rewards that you get from those decryption terminals, they're completely random. So if I was to reload my save, it would change it. Enter code. Invalid code, sequence reset. A, X. A, X, B. There we go. Wasn't too bad. Well, damn, son. Where'd you find this? That's convenient. We just press a random button and look, it works. Even though it's Prothean.
Oh, how did you get in here? I didn't think there was any way past the barrier.
Giant laser, mostly. Superior firepower. It's not important.
We have to get you out of here before more Geth arrive.
Yes, you're right. I've seen enough of them to last a lifetime. That button should shut down my containment field.
Boop.
Any idea how we get out of this place?
There is an elevator back in the center of the tower. At least I think it's an elevator. It should take us out of here. Come on. I still cannot believe all this. Why would the Geth come after me? Do you think Benezia's involved?
Yes.
Saren's looking for the conduit. You're a Prothean expert. He probably wants you to help him find it.
The conduit? But I don't know...
That?
An explosion, probably. Probably.
These ruins are not stable. That mining laser must have triggered a seismic event. We have to hurry. The whole place is caving in.
We need an escape plan.
Joker, get the Normandy airborne and lock in on my signal. On the double, mister.
Aye, aye, Commander. Secure and away. ETA 8 minutes.
Not much margin for error.
If I die in here, I'll kill him.
I'm surprised there's no, like, rocks falling or anything. Then again, it would have probably stressed the system a little bit too much, or the engine. Intimidating? Not really.
Brenda, don't have any fun.
This ruin's coming down.
In case you didn't notice, this place is falling apart.
Exhilarating, isn't it? Thanks for getting rid of those energy fields for us. Had the doctor over.
Nah.
Whatever it is you want, you are not getting it from me.
Yeah, we're not giving her up.
She'll stay with us, thanks.
Not an option. Saren wants her, and he always gets what he wants.
He's a spoiled brat, then.
Kill him. Spare the Asari if you can. None. Doesn't matter.
And we leveled up again. Okay. Analyze the situation real quick. Kill the rocket trooper. That's not good. That's not good at all. Surprise singularity.
Ow. Ow.
Wow. Okay. That just happened. Okay, well, let's end these guys first then. Yeah, okay, so it was a sniper. Alrighty, shock trooper. Where you at? It's you. Yeah, we got the battle master. Drop him like a sack of shit. He's just running around headbutting all the things. Unity. I just got a shotgun. God damn! Run, Forrest. Run. I don't remember this being this cool. GGS. Dr. Liara T'Soni.
Too close, Commander. 10 more seconds, we would have been swimming in molten sulfur. The Normandy isn't equipped to land in exploding volcanoes. They tend to fry our sensors and melt our hull. Just for future reference.
Thanks for the reference.
Died out there, and your pilot is making jokes?
Well, he did save us.
Joker pulled our asses out of there. I think he's earned the right to a few bad jokes.
I see. It must be a human thing. I don't have a lot of experience dealing with your species, Commander. But I am grateful to you. You saved my life back there, and not just from the volcano. Those Geth would have killed me or dragged me off to Saren.
What did Saren want with you? Do you know something about the conduit?
Only that it was somehow connected to the Prothean extinction. That is my real area of expertise. I have spent the past 50 years trying to figure out what happened to them.
50 years. And this is where we find out about Asari lifespans.
How old are you exactly?
I hate to admit it, but I am only 106.
Damn! I hope I look that good when I'm your age.
A century may seem like a long time to a short-lived species like yours. But among the Asari, I am barely considered more than a child. That is why my research has not received the attention it deserves. Because of my youth, other Asari scholars tend to dismiss my theories on what happened to the Protheans.
I think I might know.
I've got my own theory on why the Protheans disappeared.
With all due respect, Commander, I have heard every theory out there. The problem is finding evidence to support them. The Protheans left remarkably little behind. It is almost as if someone did not want the mystery solved. It is like someone came along after the Protheans were gone and cleansed the galaxy of clues. But here is the incredible part. According to my findings, the Protheans were not the first galactic civilization to mysteriously vanish. This cycle began long before them.
And how do you know this?
Where'd you come up with this theory? I thought there wasn't any evidence.
I have been working on this for 50 years. I have tracked down every scrap and shred of evidence. Eventually, subtle patterns start to emerge. Patterns that hint at the truth. It is difficult to explain to someone else. I cannot point to one specific thing to prove my case. It is more a feeling derived from a half century of dedicated research. But I know I'm right, and eventually I will be able to prove it. There were other civilizations before the Protheans. This cycle has repeated itself many times over.
So who came before them?
If the Protheans weren't the first, then who was?
I don't know. There is barely any evidence on the Protheans, even less on those who came before them. I cannot prove my theory, but I know I am right. The galaxy is built on a cycle of extinction. Each time a great civilization rises up, it is suddenly and violently cast down. Only ruins survive. The Protheans rose up from a single world until their empire spanned the entire galaxy. Yet even they climbed to the top on the remains of those who came before. Their greatest achievements, the mass relays and the citadel, are based on the technology of those who came before them. And then, like all the other forgotten civilizations throughout galactic history, the Protheans disappeared. I have dedicated my life to figuring out why.
And I can help you.
They were wiped out by a race of sentient machines. The Reapers.
The Reapers? But I have never heard of... How do you know this? What evidence do you have?
The beacon. A vision. I saw it.
There was a damaged Prothean beacon on Eden Prime. It burned a vision into my brain. I'm still trying to sort out what it all means.
Visions. Yes, that makes sense. The beacons were designed to transmit information directly into the mind of the user. Finding one that still works is extremely rare. No wonder the Geth attacked Eden Prime. The chance to acquire a working beacon, even a badly damaged one, is worth almost any risk. But the beacons were only programmed to interact with Prothean physiology. Whatever information you received would have been confused, unclear. I am amazed you were able to make sense of it at all. A lesser mind would have been utterly destroyed by the process. You must be remarkably strong-willed, Commander.
Okay, this isn't helping us find Saren or the Conduit.
Of course, you are right. I am sorry, my scientific curiosity got the better of me. Unfortunately, I do not have any information that could help you find the Conduit, or Saren.
But you can still help us.
I don't know why Saren wanted you out of the picture, but I think we'll be a lot better off if we bring you along.
Thank you, Commander. Saren might come after me again. I cannot think of anywhere safer than here on your ship. And my knowledge of the Protheans might be useful later on.
And her biotics will come in handy when the fighting starts.
Welcome aboard.
Good to have you on the team, Liara.
Thank you, Commander. I am very grateful. Oh, I am afraid I am feeling a bit lightheaded.
When was the last time you ate or slept? Dr. Chakwa should take a look at you.
It is probably just mental exhaustion. Coupled with the shock of discovering the Prothean's true fate. I need some time to process all this. Still, it could not hurt to be examined by a medical professional. It will give me the chance to think things over. Are we finished here, Commander?
We will talk later.
We can talk again after you've seen the doctor. The rest of you, dismissed.
Mission reports are filed, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
You can deny them. All you want, but yeah, sure.
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
We've received your report, Commander. I understand Dr. T'Soni is on the Normandy.
I assume you're taking the necessary security precautions.
And she wants to help us.
Liara's on our side. The Geth were trying to kill her.
Benezia would never allow Saren to kill her daughter.
Maybe she doesn't know.
Or maybe we don't know her. We never expected she could become a traitor.
At least the mission was a success.
Apart from the utter destruction of a major Prothean ruin. Was that really necessary, Shepard?
Disconnect. Yes, yes it was. Sad, but necessary.
The Geth were crawling all over those ruins. We were lucky to make it out alive.
Of course, Commander. The mission must always take priority.
Good luck, Commander. Remember, we are all counting on you.
Well, damn. Oh, can I? Oh, I can examine that. Okay. Squad. Let's level up a little bit. That was pretty darn brutal, I must admit. Spectre training. Oh wait, no, we need to go find Liara, don't we? Point system defense. For the life of me, I do not remember where she's at. That's Caden right there. Let's get an idea of what you felt during the last mission.
Anything you need, Commander?
Looking for personal input.
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
Is this an official evaluation, Commander? Or off the record?
Speak your mind, Caden.
Alenko, when it's just you and me, you can consider it off the record.
That's a generous attitude. Okay. I think there's something wrong with all this. This Saren is looking for records on some kind of galactic extinction, but we can't get backup from the Council? Sorry, Commander. There's writing on the wall here, but someone isn't reading it.
Yeah. I know.
The Council doesn't want to believe anything's wrong. I'd call it human nature, but...
I hear you. It just seems like a group that's been around as long as the Council should see this coming. Sorry if I got too informal. Protocol wasn't a big focus back in Bot.
Yeah, it's all right.
Biotic acclimation and temperance didn't last past the airlock. To the kids they hauled in, it was brain camp. Sorry, hauled in is unkind. We were encouraged to commit to an evaluation of our abilities so an understanding of biotics could be compiled.
Of course.
There are worse results of accidental exposure to element zero in the womb. Beats the brain tumors some kids grew up with.
Yeah, that's pretty bad. You thought it was accidental, though? Because, well, yeah.
Is there some question about how you were exposed?
My mother was downwind of a transport crash. It was before there were human biotics, a little after the discovery of the Martian ruins. It only gets iffy around 63 when Kinetics was running out of first-gen subjects. Until then, they'd relied on accidentals. A bunch of guys in suits show up at your door after school, and next thing you know, you're out on Jump Zero.
Jump Zero.
It's Gagarin Station, right? What's it like?
Yeah, that's the official name. Biggest and farthest facility we had for decades. Right on the termination shock, the outer edge of the solar system. It's where they did all the goose chase FTL research before we caught on to using mass effect fields. It was a sterile research platform when I was there.
What about friends?
There were other kids in the same boat, right? At least you weren't alone out there.
That's true. We did have a little circle that'd get together every night before lights out. We didn't have much to do, though. It was a research platform then, and Kinetics kept Jump Zero off the extranet to prevent leaks.
Time to talk, then. Time to get physical, then.
Then you must have had plenty of time to get to know each other.
Yeah, we'd sit around and bowl every night after dinner, play cards or network games. There was this girl named Rana, who had a little circle grow up around her. She was from Turkey. Her family was very rich. But she was smart and charming as hell. Beautiful, but not stuck up about it. I think you'd have liked her.
Did you like her, Caden?
Sounds like she was special to you.
She was. Maybe she felt the same. But things never felt together. Training, you know.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
Intentional exposures for certain?
No one knows. Doesn't mean they didn't happen. As big as the exposures were, it was hard to track down accidentals. It was different then. No one knew the potential, so there wasn't a lot of regulation. Anything Kinetics did was gold. I'm not saying they intentionally detonated drives over our outposts, but in retrospect, They were damn quick on the scene.
Yeah, it sounds pretty bad. But he is telling the truth, though.
Jump Zero is a long way from home. What was it like?
The grand gateway to humanity looks a lot better in the vids. But that's my own baggage, Commander. No bearing on this.
You can talk to me, you know.
Blanco, there's no regulation that says you can't be friends with your commander.
I appreciate that, Commander. I just don't want you to think that I'm a whiner. Besides, I've got my past squared away.
Good little talk.
Anything you need, Commander?
Tactical appraisal.
What's your opinion on the last mission?
Dr. T'Soni. Seems like a sweet girl. Easy on the eyes. I mean, if you like the bookish sort.
Fuck. Oh, I do. Do you?
Any intentions there, Lieutenant?
No, Commander. Just art appreciation.
What's your opinion on the line?
I mean, if you
just
like...
Get the other answer.
Just remember, Lieutenant, I saw her first.
Only by a few seconds, sir.
I called dibs, Caden.
We'll
God
talk
damn
another
it.
Time, Commander.
I called dibs. Dr. Chakwas. Is she in here? She's not.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
Don't.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
I should go. Here she is. Hello, Liara.
Commander, are you coming to check up on me?
I was slightly worried.
You look much better. How are you feeling?
Dr. Chakwas assures me I am going to be fine. I was impressed with her knowledge of Asari physiology.
She's the best.
You're in good hands. Dr. Chakwas knows what she's doing.
I never properly thanked you for saving me from the Geth, Commander. If you hadn't shown up,
it's
fine. I'm just glad we got there in time.
So am I. I know you took a chance bringing me aboard this ship. I have seen the way your crew looks at me. They do not trust me. But I am not
odd.
Benezia. I will do whatever I can to help you stop Saren. I promise.
I know.
Don't worry, Liara. I trust you. I know you won't let me down.
It means a lot to hear you say that, Commander. Thank you.
I'd like to talk about
you. Tell me about yourself, Liara.
Me? I am afraid I am not very interesting, Commander. I spend most of my time on remote digs, unearthing mundane items buried in long-forgotten Prothean ruins.
You must get lonely.
Sounds dangerous.
God damn it.
And lonely.
Sometimes I would run afoul of indigenous life forms or stumble across a small band of mercenaries or privateers, but I was always careful. Until the Geth followed me to Artemis Tau, I never found myself in any situation my biotics could not handle. As for the solitude, well, that is one aspect that most appealed to me. Sometimes I just need to get away from other people.
Yeah, I get that. But why is it?
You don't
why
like
is it
other
that?
People?
I suppose it comes from being a matriarch's daughter. People expected me to follow in Benezia's footsteps. They wanted me to become a leader of our people. Matriarchs guide their followers into the future. They seek the truth of what is yet to come. Maybe that's why I became so interested in the secrets of the past. It sounds so foolish when I say it out loud. It sounds like I became an archaeologist simply to spite Benezia.
Well... maybe a little bit of both.
All children rebel against their parents. It's a natural part of growing up.
Uh-huh. You share the wisdom of the matriarch, Shepard. That is exactly what Benezia said when I told her of my decision. But there was more to it than that. I felt drawn to the past. The Protheans were these wondrous, mysterious figures. I wanted to know everything about them. That is why I find you so fascinating. You were marked by the beacon on Eden Prime. You were touched by working Prothean technology.
I'm fascinating. Just to go off in a little tangent real quick. I get where she's coming from. Because in the Halo series, like prior to Halo 4, I had like this big fucking obsession with Forerunners and just trying to understand them. But yeah, just nerd talk. But I'm fascinated.
Like you want to dissect me in a lab somewhere.
What? No, I did not mean to insinuate. I never meant to offend you, Shepard. I only meant that you would be an interesting specimen for an in-depth study. No, that's even worse.
Chill, Liara. Chill. Down, Liara.
I was only joking.
Joking? Oh, by the goddess, how could I be so dense? You must think I am a complete and utter fool. Now you know why I prefer to spend my time in the field with data disks and computers. I always seem to say something embarrassing around other people. Please, just pretend this conversation never happened.
No. We're going to remember this conversation. Venezia.
Do you know why Venezia joined up with Saren?
I don't understand it. She was always outspoken about the need for the Asari to become more involved in shaping galactic events. Maybe she thought allying herself with Saren would somehow be for the greater good in the long run. At least I hope so.
You sound troubled.
Doesn't it?
None of this makes any sense to me. I have not spoken to Venezia in many years, but I know her, and this was not like her. Something changed.
Do you know why?
We'll skip this part real quick.
With Saren would somehow be for the greater good in the long run.
I'd like to know more about the Asari.
We were the first species to discover the Citadel. We were instrumental in forming the Council, and we always strive to be the voice of peaceful cooperation in galactic disputes. My people believe we are all part of a single galactic community. Each species contributes something to the greater whole. Although we seek to understand other species, it seems few of them seek to understand us. The galaxy is filled with rumors and misinformation about my people.
Okay, so you're like Space Sweden. Yeah, we'll go with that. That makes sense. Rumors.
What? Most of the inaccuracies are centered around our mating rituals. My species is monogendered. Male and female have no real meaning for us. We still require a partner to reproduce. This second parent, however, may be of any species and any gender.
That's disgusting. Hot.
I don't understand. Your species can mate with anyone?
Mating is not quite the proper term, not as you understand it. Physical contact may or may not be involved, but it is not an essential element of the union. The true connection is mental. Our physiology allows us to meld with other beings. We can touch the very depths of their minds. We explore the genetic memory of their species. We share the most basic elements of their individual and racial identities. We then pass these traits on to our daughters. It is how we learn to grow as a species and how we develop a greater understanding of other races.
What about the other parent?
What happens to your partner after the union?
Every relationship is different. Some unions are a single encounter with both parents parting ways afterwards.
One night stand.
Others can be more long term. Sometimes an Asari and her partner will stay together for many decades.
Who was your father? Wow. Blunt.
Do you know who Matriarch Venezia chose as her partner?
She rarely spoke of her partner. Though I know my father, if you want to use that term, was another Asari.
You can do that?
I thought you always needed another species to serve as one of the parents.
Think about it, Shepard. If we were not able to mate with our own species, we would have died out long before we ever mastered spaceflight and left our homeworld. Union with our own kind is no longer common, not for the purposes of reproduction. Most Asari believe it weakens our species. Asari daughters inherit racial traits from the father species. If both parents are Asari, then nothing has been gained. Or so conventional wisdom would hold. I am what is sometimes called a pureblood, though no Asari would ever be cruel enough to say the word to my face. It is a great insult among my people. It is possible Benezia's partner was embarrassed by their union. She may have been too ashamed to publicly acknowledge me as her offspring.
Ah, you don't know
Maybe
that.
Maybe she wanted to meet you but couldn't. Something could have happened to her. Maybe she passed away.
You might be right. I hope you are. But I have no way to know for sure. Venezia never spoke of her partner. Whatever happened, it caused her too much pain to dwell on it. She raised me by herself, though that is not uncommon. Many Asari raise their children alone, particularly if the father species is short-lived. Often the partner will pass on long before the child reaches maturity.
How do they deal with that?
Asari live for 1,000 years. What happens when your partner dies?
Few sapient species live as long as my kind. We have learned to take a philosophical approach to our unions. We do not focus on the inevitable loss of our partners. Instead, we enjoy the time we spend with them. And even after they're gone, a part of them lives on in us. The union is a connection that transcends both time and space.
There was one more question.
Like what?
We still require a partner to reproduce. We then pass
what about the other parent?
Others can be more long-term. Sometimes
oh, no.
Sorry,
we're all done. Okay.
Stay together.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
Cool. Alrighty. Well, let's go to the hangar and talk to... What's her face? Ashley. I want to see if Garrus and Rex have anything new to say. I doubt they will, but it's always worth knowing. But yeah, Dr. Liara T'Soni. We're going to be romancing the absolute hell out of her. Let us try Garrus first. Make a quick little save.
Commander, what can I do for you?
What's the matter?
Bothering you? It's Saren. I'm starting to wonder whether we'll ever find him. He's always one step ahead of us, and he's got those damn Geth.
You think he'll get away?
We're getting close, Garrus. We'll find him.
I wish I had your confidence. I just can't stand the thought of him getting away with everything he's done.
He won't.
I know you're doing everything you can, and if anyone can catch him, it's you, but... If there's anything
but.
Else I can do to help, anything, just tell me what you want me to do, and I'll do it.
Are you worried?
I understand your concern, but we'll find him. Just make sure you're ready to go when we do.
Yes, sir. I'll be ready. Can I ask you something, Commander?
Sure.
What is it?
Are you worried that the Council might be protecting Saren? I mean, they were really dragging their heels before. What if we find him, bring him back to the Citadel, and they refuse to act?
I doubt it.
I get the feeling this isn't a question. Speak your mind, Garrus.
Well, maybe we shouldn't give them the chance, Commander. In my opinion, Saren's too dangerous to be kept alive. Too much could happen. He could escape, or the Council might let him go. If we find him, when we find him, I say we make sure we stop him permanently.
You see, somebody else fought that, like that. His name was Mace Windu, and that didn't work out so well for him. It's a last resort, though.
If Saren won't listen to reason, if he forces my hand, I'll kill him in a heartbeat. But only if it's absolutely necessary.
But what's the point in keeping him alive? It just gives him an opportunity to escape or convince the Council to listen to him. And what about the Geth? They might try to free him.
But think about it.
We know more about Saren's plans than anyone. But what do we really know? If we just kill him, we lose the chance to find out.
Yeah, I see your point. Do you really think there's more to know, other than the fact that he's a raving lunatic?
Tiny bit, yeah.
Maybe, maybe not. But it's not a chance I'm willing to take.
Yes, sir.
Good thing we came down here, then. Okay, Rex, you're up next. I wonder if Talley's got anything new to say. I doubt it.
Shepard?
Personal
so
inquiry.
You'd rather be a merc than help your people.
I'm a fighter. It's what I do.
Aren't you all worried about what will happen to the Krogan?
What the hell do you want me to do about it, Shepard? I'm tired of sticking my ass on the line and getting nothing for it.
That's your reason?
So you're just giving up on your people?
I gave up on fighting for a lost cause. I'm not like you, Shepard. I'm no hero. Bottom line... Killing for credits simplifies things.
Sometimes.
You ever think about helping your people?
I try not to. But there's a lot of Krogan mercs out there. I'm always running into them. Half the time I'm being paid to kill them. But that's just part of the job. You don't get to pick who your enemies are.
Mercenary.
How long have you been a merc?
Long enough. I took my first contract right after I left my home system. It's good work if it doesn't kill you.
You like it then?
I get a feeling you enjoy your work.
Sure. You get to see the galaxy on someone else's credits, and most days end with a good fight.
Krogan.
I've tried more organized fighting, private armies and such, but it gets too messy. I fight best on my own, or in very small groups. I don't like people relying on me, and I bloody well don't like relying on them.
That's a little bit close-minded, Rex.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Ah, you can tell he wants to do good. He really does, but he's just been held back.
Oh, before I go, you said you're serving with Commander Shepard now? We saw him on the news here. He's cute. Later, sis.
Tell me you didn't hear that.
Every single word of it.
I did.
Oh, shoot me now. One of my sisters. That's Sarah, the youngest. Surprised to see you here, sir. Thought you'd be chatting up, what's her name? T'Soni?
Oh, I was. Jealous, Ashley?
Liara, why would you think that?
Scuttlebutt says you got a bit of a thing for her. I could understand why. The crew's off limits with the regs against fraternization. And at least she looks like a woman.
Oh. Some deep, deep hatred right there. Deep-centered hatred.
You think I'm interested in Liara because she's the only one I'm allowed to date?
So you are interested in her. Of course, it could be politics. Alien diplomat's daughter, us under orders to make nice with the bug-eyed monsters. What's up? You didn't come by to eavesdrop on family mail.
God damn, she is heartless.
Your family seems to be important to you.
Yeah, we've always been close. Me and my sisters especially. With Dad on duty so much, I had to help Mom raise them.
Your dad?
Did your father serve with the fleet?
Yeah. Took any crap posting he could get that offered space time. You know what? He worked his ass off trying to get recognized, but he never made it above serviceman third class. He was real proud when I made chief. First thing he did was salute.
Your mom?
Your mother. You haven't mentioned her.
You must know what military wives are like. Strong because they have to be, able to raise kids while Dad's away on a 6-month cruise. She has a degree in planetary geology. She and Dad both wanted to see new worlds. She gave up her career to raise us, though.
Ooh.
You have
your
more
sisters.
Than one sister? Sounds like a big family.
Yeah, I'm the oldest, then Abby, then Lynn. Sarah's the youngest. She's still in high school. With four girls, Dad used to say he felt more outnumbered at home than on maneuvers.
What about at home?
Where did you grow up?
All over. We transferred a half a dozen times before I finished grade school. You go where personnel command sends you, right? I guess that's why I'm so tight with my sisters. We'd have to leave all our friends every 2 or 3 years.
That sucks. You raised your sisters?
After helping raise them, your sisters still talk to you? Amazing.
Things were tense between Sarah and me for a while. Then we bonded.
Sounds like a story. Tell me about it. Feel like sharing?
Sarah got herself a boyfriend who wanted to go faster than she did. Mike. I didn't think he was a bad kid, just pushy. Lynn would send me these worried vidmails, and I'd tell her to relax.
Vidmails?
Where were you when this was going on?
I was on active duty. Sarah's graduating high school this year. This was only a couple of years back. They were on Amaterasu. At the time, I was assigned to Chernobyl. Same cluster, but a dozen LY away. Close enough to talk regularly, too far to make it back in an emergency. I couldn't afford a fast packet flight.
Okay. No means no.
If he really liked her, he wouldn't be pushy.
Yeah, of course. If he didn't ask at all, I'd wonder if he thought Sarah was ugly. Damned if you do, damned if you don't. Mike thought they'd go for a romantic walk in the woods, because he figured it was past time they did the deed. She levered Mike face first into a tree and left. Didn't have a scratch on her. Good thing Mom and Dad had us all learn some kind of self-defense.
Good honor.
I took emergency leave and walked Sarah to school for a few days.
Police?
Why didn't you tell the police?
She said it wouldn't solve the real problem, and she and Mike would both become household names. It was a small colony. I said it was her call to make, that we should let her do it her way. Mom was pretty pissed about that.
You said self-defense? Learn self-defense?
Lynn did pistol practice, but didn't like it. She's kind of nervous. Sarah took Aikido. Abby decided to learn the sword. She always was a little weird. Likes big skirts and tops you have to tie her into. They do great things to her figure, though.
What about you?
So, what did you learn?
One of Dad's friends taught me Marine hand-to-hand.
Of course. Of course. Pretty glad to get it up here.
You traveled all the way home to walk your sister to school.
It was only a dozen light years. Like a day's cruise. It's not like it was going to Earth or something. My last day out, Mike was waiting for us. Sarah had told her friends, so everyone at school knew what he did. He wasn't happy. I wanted to snap him in half, but Sarah gave me this look, this let me handle it, I need to do this alone look. She kept her cool, God bless her, as he screamed in her face. She just let him vent. Then he tried to punch her.
Ooh.
I swear, she just flowed around him. Next thing I knew, he's face down on the sidewalk, and there's blood everywhere.
Serves him right.
That's unbelievable. Sarah must be as good as you.
Better. I'm more or less a straight-up puncher. When he swung, she wasn't there anymore, and he fell. She helped him stop the bleeding and had me call an ambulance. She told the paramedics he fell. Before they took him to the hospital, Mike touched Sarah's arm. I thought he was going to end up on the ground again. But he hung his head, whispered, "I'm sorry," and started crying. And she hugged him. The Williams women are a decisive bunch, Commander. We do things when we're ready. Not before, not after.
Hinting at something, Ashley?
Your sister's something else. But you didn't mention your father at all. Was he on deployment?
Dad always wanted to serve in space, but he wanted us to have real ground under our feet. He'd say, space is beautiful, but you can't raise a family there. I cannot rest from travel. I will drink life to the lees. All times I've enjoyed greatly have suffered greatly, both with those that loved me and alone. For always roaming with a hungry heart, much have I seen and known. Cities of men and manners, climates, councils, governments.
Not a big fan of poetry.
I never thought I'd hear you reciting poetry.
Just because I can drill you between the eyes at 100 meters doesn't mean I can't like sensitive stuff. Ulysses was my dad's favorite poem. Every time he shipped out, he recorded me reading it. He had a dozen versions when he retired.
That's a good piece.
Like it?
I sure hope so. I read it to his grave every time I go home.
Oh.
Dad passed on a few years back. He's probably still watching, though. So
you're religious. From the afterlife.
Wherever we go after death.
Dead on, Skipper. He's with God now. That's not a problem with you, is it? That I believe in God?
Of course not. Yeah, of course
Everyone
not.
Everyone has the right to believe what they want. Says so in the Alliance Charter. Only with fancier words.
I'm glad you're open-minded about it. I've met a few people who were really weirded out by my faith. Because I work in space, I can't believe in a higher power? Jeez. Hello, have you people looked out the window? How can you look at this galaxy and not believe in something? I should get back to my duties. Didn't mean to take up so much of your time.
Eh, no problem. How
What's
we doing?
Your opinion on the last mission?
Not sure I buy Dr. T'Soni's story about her and her mom not talking. They're family, right?
I believe her, though.
I think she's being straight with us. Or at least, I don't think she lies very often.
Yeah, she's probably really bad at it. Hey, want me to ask her about her sex life? Might be illuminating.
God damn it. Don't be cruel.
I don't think she's used to teasing. Good-natured or otherwise.
Aw, no fun, Skipper. Too bad those ruins got destroyed. I mean, they lasted thousands of years. That's impressive.
We'll
True that.
Later,
True that.
Looking forward to it, Skipper.
Okay. Bunch of crew talk. Starting the tally. Bloody Nora. Can I examine? I can.
Oh, hello, Shepard.
You sound upset, Tally. What's up?
Are you okay?
I don't know. Your ship is amazing, and your crew's been really great to me. Especially your chief engineer. But I just sort of feel out of place.
Why so?
The Normandy runs so smooth, it feels like we're not even moving. And the engines are so quiet. How do you sleep at night?
It's too quiet to sleep?
The silence wakes you up.
Back on the flotilla, the last thing you want to hear is silence. It means an engine's died or an air filter shut down. I guess you don't have to worry about that here. But old habits die hard. But it's more than just a silence. This ship feels so empty. It's like half the crew is missing. Back home, I couldn't wait to go on my pilgrimage. I couldn't wait to get away from the crowds. Now that I'm out here, I kind of miss them.
So you're a little bit homesick. I get that. You know, you want something so much, and then when what you have is gone, you start to miss it. It's understandable.
Sometimes we don't appreciate what we have until it's gone.
Bingo.
It's true. I'm starting to wonder if that's what the pilgrimage is really about. It's given me a whole new perspective on my people and our culture. You know, there's always a few who go on their pilgrimages and never return. I always assumed something bad happened to them. But maybe they just wanted a different life.
But you're going back, right?
You do plan to return to the migrant fleet, right?
I could never abandon my people, Shepard. I will go back eventually. But we have to stop Saren first. Otherwise, I might not have a home to go back to.
True. True, true.
See you later.
Hasta la pasta. Wow, so, bunch of talk in this episode. Where are we off to next? Check the journal real quick. Rogue VI, where's that at? Oh, it's in the Sol system. Harvest Moon, okay. Just want to check how many things we've completed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. 19, 20, 21, 22. Okay, so I'm gonna say 21. It's not too bad. The Fun, the Missing Marines. The Sparta Cluster. This is Sparta! So apparently to get the achievements for the allies, which is like taking the crew members through the majority of the game, you need to complete 50 assignments with them, from what I've read. So, that's gonna be fun. Let's go to the Sparta Cluster. Is there anything out here? Right there. An asteroid. No, we already scanned that. Athens. Go to Sparta.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
Commander Shepard, my name is Nasana Dantius. I have a job for you. I can't say any more in an unsecured communication. If you're interested in hearing my offer, meet me on the Citadel so we can talk in person. I'll be waiting in the diplomat's lounge on the Presidium.
Okay. That's not ominous. Asteroid. Ah, bugger. Didn't even check to read that. Proofing data disk. Well, you guys can pause the video if you want to check that out. I know I probably will.
Commander, I'm picking up a signal from the planet's surface. It looks like an automated distress beacon.
Okay. So we're going here next, apparently. So much dialogue! So different. It's a nice change from things, you know, stops it from getting bland. Check this asteroid belt. Nothing out here. Okay, was it here? Balata? No. Altia? Yeah, it's the one on the left. God dang it. Idolos. That looks like a silo. And I don't trust things out in the middle of the open. Because fresher mob blows. Oh yeah, that's totally not. Good thing I saved. On pressure, Ma. You can do it. There we go. I gotta save so we don't have to fight that bloody thing again. Alliance Marine. What happened to these guys?
Like they were lured here by the distress beacon.
So do we destroy it?
We need to tell them what happened here.
Oh no, we find the missing Marines. Okay. Well, we find the missing Marines. Good on us. Okay, everyone, I think that's going to wrap it up for today. Next time, we're going to tell the Admiral what happened to his Marines. Go to the Citadel to pick up that other quest, and probably take out those two crime lords. And then maybe, just maybe, I might either do the Horde-based one or the Asteroid one, DLC. I'm like blanking on their names right now. So I'm going to look at the galaxy map real quick, just so I know what I'm talking about. Okay, so yeah, Pinnacle Station or Asteroid X-57. And we'll do either one of those next time as well. But yeah, like I said, for now, that's going to wrap it up. Once again, I've been SOLIDSNAKEE, and I shall speak to you all next time. Later, guys.